feel uh-huh. Dirty South, dirt. Can y'all really feel I got the East Coast feel West Coast feel Dirty South, dirty. Can y'all really feel me? Really? East Coast feel. Say what? Hey guys, it's me, Lydia Marie. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I am doing this nice, gorgeous makeup look using some of the luxury and higher end products that I have in my stash. I'm still shopping my stash because it's February. You guys know I've been on a no buy for this month, but I went through my stash and I was like, you know what? I need to use some of these luxury products, some of these items that you can get from Neiman Marcus and Nordstrom Beauty and things like that. Some of the things that I haven't reached for in quite some time. So if you would like to see how I got this makeup look using some of my higher end luxury products, I hope that you would keep watching. Hello to my new subscribers. It's good to have y'all over here on the Beauty Fam, and hi to my A1 Day Ones. I see y'all as well. Welcome back. Before we get started, I just want to thank you for supporting and booking appointments for my online beauty consulting business. I am so appreciative of the love that you guys have shown. If you would like to book an appointment for a one-on-one makeup lesson or consulting with your skincare, virtual shopping, anything like that, that will be the first link in my description box. So go ahead and book your appointments today. And again, I thank you guys so much for your support. Let's go ahead and get into this luxury product makeup look. So I guess my first question would be, what do you all consider to be luxury? Do you consider a luxury item to be based on the brand as a whole of a luxury item, or do you think it's more based in price, in your personal opinion? I think it's a little bit of both. Like, to me, this Bobbi Brown Vitamin Enriched Serum, which is what I'm using to prime my face, to me, this is a more luxury item because Bobbi Brown is a more upscale makeup brand, something that you can find in a higher end department store, which is something that I will also consider luxury. Like, I can find this at Nordstrom Beauty or at Neiman Marcus Beauty Counter and things like that. And along with the price, because for this, if you were to buy it, it's like $68. Worth it to me, but that was something that I would consider luxury. So what do you all consider luxury beauty items? Do you go more on the price, or do you go more on the brand, or is it a little bit of both? Let me know. I also took a little bit of the Clarins. This is the pore filling makeup primer. It's called the Instant Smooth Primer. Even though I got this in a gift set with the Clarins, it's still rather pricey on its own, but it is so good, and I only put it where my pores tend to show the most, which is right here on my cheeks and a little bit in my forehead. A little bit of this goes a very long way. Speaking of products that go a very long way, and definitely to me is something that is considered luxury or high end, this is my Kevin Aucoin Central Skin Enhancer. I have the shade, of course I can't find it, but it's on the bottle and I will link it below. This is a concealer slash color corrector slash skin enhancer, I guess you could say. And Kevin Aucoin is definitely a brand to me that is higher end. You cannot find this just anywhere. You can find a few things on Sephora, but really just on his website, on Neiman Marcus, Nordstrom, things like that. But a little bit of this goes a very long way, and I like to use it under my eyes. It is helping to conceal and also neutralize the color. You can see I have so much left because you really only need a drop of this so it won't be cakey. It's such a smoothing concealer type product, especially under my eyes, and it's literally just going to neutralize the color under my eyes. I'm going to show you how. I have about that much on my brush, and I'm going to wipe some of that off because this is very full coverage. I'm just taking some on my hand. This is what it looks like. And I am going to just kind of tap that in and with the brush, and then I'm going to just tap it in with my fingers. I should say apply it with the brush and then tap it in with my fingers. And this is more closer to my skin tone, so it's not going to be orange like a color corrector, but it is very smoothing. It's a very smoothing concealer type product under here. And my dark circles are doing the most, so I'm just going to take a little bit down there. I'm taking my Bobbi Brown color corrector in the shade Deep Peach. The goal with that Kevin Aucoin skin enhancer is
to kind of set the foundation, and I put on just a smidge so that I can put my color corrector in later on after foundation, add a brightening concealer. But I'm doing this shade in Deep Peach. Like I said, I have dark circles. I don't know what's up with my sinuses, if I have some sort of sinus infection, but because I've been sneezing and taking antihistamines, my dark circles are doing the most. So I just kind of want to neutralize it. You guys know I am not super pressed all the time to cover up every single blemish. I just want my makeup to look even, and I am not as self-conscious about my hyperpigmentation as I used to be. I'm mainly color correct just to get my makeup to look even once I apply it. For my foundation, I'm going in with the Givenchy Prisme Libre. I think to me this is about as high-end as I have a foundation, and it's about as oh my gosh, talking about luxury, and the top just fell off. Please hold. Now that I think about it, that top has been broken since I got that bottle. That little pump would not stay on. Anyway, this is a Givenchy Prisme Libre Skin Caring Glow Foundation, and I did a full video on it when I first got it, and I had to go back and get another shade, which I think the shade is still a pretty good match, even in the winter. I think it's still a pretty good match, but I do like this a lot because it is medium buildable. It's not full coverage, so I can take a little bit more where I feel like I need it, but for now, I just applied it with my finger. Oops, I don't want to break my mirror. I just applied it with my fingers, and I just like to tap it in and go all over my face. So I just went ahead and applied that all over my face. I really like how it gave me a nice even finish and a glowing finish. I even was able to build it up a little bit more on my cheek where my hyperpigmentation is, but I just really like how that gives me a nice glow after I put it on. And I'm in the shade 5N345. Of course, you know I'm gonna have everything linked below, and I just used about 2.5 pumps, which is a lot of foundation, but I am going for a full face today. And whatever was left, I just added it to my forehead. And don't forget to bring your foundation back. The other day I took a photo, and I obviously was in a rush because my foundation stopped like right here. And I was like, girl, absolutely not. For concealers, I'm giving myself two. I'm using the Givenchy Prisme Libre Skin Caring Glow Concealer, which coordinates with the foundation, and I just put that in the corner of my eye. On the outer corner, I put the Bobbi Brown Full Coverage Concealer. This is in the shade Deep Honey. Yeah, Deep Honey, and it's a little bit more golden. And I just kind of put that on my chin and on the outer side, and I gave my face a quick spritz with the Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Filter Setting Spray. This is a setting spray, but I like to use it kind of as a finishing spray in between like this. I can go ahead and give my face a spritz to hold everything, start melding the foundation into place, start melding this concealer in before I blend it out. This Bobbi Brown concealer is full coverage. It dries down fairly quickly, so I'm just going to start blending that out, and I'm going to blend it up towards the tail end of my brows just for a nice lifted look. Spraying your face in between products helps the makeup melt in and kind of helps things just blend in a little bit more smoothly. I have a dense brush that I'm just tapping this concealer in, and then I'm going to go over it with a damp smaller beauty sponge just to make sure it is nice and melted in. I love these two concealers together, not just for the brightness, but baby, this Givenchy and that Bobbi Brown will cover all of your sins, okay? I mean, really, it is a great combination. I just realized I don't have a quote-unquote higher-end bronzer concealer product, a bronzer contour product that I know of. If I do, I can't find it, but that's okay. LYS screams luxury at an affordable price. So I'm using my LYS bronzer contour stick in the shade Harmony. It's warmer. It's not as dark as Confident, which is the other one that I have, but it's going to give me just enough of a nice bronzer slash contour situation that I want today with this cream sort of base that I have going on. So I'm just using that as my contour. I really am loving how my complexion is just looking already. Truthfully, I could just add a blush and be on my way in a lip, and I think this will be good. But I want to do some eyes today, so I'm going to be using the Natasha Denona Glam Face Palette. This is in a dark shade. This is well worn, but I haven't used it in quite some time, and I really like it. You guys know how I feel about a nice all-inclusive palette. She has everything laid out here for like the transition, the eyelid, the smoke, everything like that. So she has everything you need in here, including a highlighter and a blush. And I do have an affiliate code for Natasha Denona. You can save a little bit money by using my code. I'm going to place that down below. But we're going to start in and just do an eye look using this palette. I'm going to start the build with the transition shade right here. They don't have names. She just said it's transition with a fluffy brush. And honestly, I could just use this in my crease. It's dark enough to just use in my crease. I easily could have gotten a light palette, but the blushes and the highlighters were a little too pale for my liking. Even though I have fair skin, but I like dark, sultry things. You know, that's kind of my vibe. I'm more of that, you know, I like to put that on, you know what I mean? But Natasha Denona is everything luxury, honey, because these eyeshadows are just, whoo. I think, to me, she kind of has Huda Beauty beat when it comes to the formula of the eyeshadow. To me, her formula is, like, spectacular. Just blending that in right there. I'm going to go in with this dark color right here. It says smoke, so we're going to use that to smoke out my outer V. Again, these shadows are insanely pigmented, so I'm just going to take and start packing it on. And I'm also going to use this for my eyeliner. Ooh, that is so pretty. I'm also going to use this for my eyeliner shade. I'm just packing that in, and I want to leave it right here in the corner. I don't want to be smoky all over. And then I'm just going to blend that out with a fluffy brush and do the same on the other side. I'm going to take a little bit more of that smoky color with this fluffy brush and just kind of build that up right over top of that brown. I like the way it's looking, but I don't want it to be a subtle smoke. I want it to be a smoky smoke. So I changed my mind. I said, no, not a lot of smoke, but you know what? This is working for me. And just give me a little bit of that. Ooh, give me the drama. Don't worry, we're going to clean this up. Don't even trip. I know how it be. And I'm going to take a little bit of this brown crease color on the same fluffy brush and just kind of go right over that transition shade. You see what I'm doing? And just kind of work that in. These shadows is just, whew, so gorgeous. And there you have the darkness, the smoke, and everything. And I'm going to do the same on this side after I clean this mess up. OMG. For my lid shade, I honestly could leave it right here because it's so pretty and so smoky. But for my lid shade, I'm going to take a color from the Natasha Denona Mini Glam Palette. And I'm going to use this kind of a bronzy shimmer. Right? Or should I use the golden shimmer? I think I'm going to use the bronzy shimmer and just kind of put that on my eyelid. You know what? Actually, I'm gonna make the two meet in the middle. That's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna do a little bit of both and put that on my lid. There we go. A little pop of color that's not too champagne, but it's also not too bronzy. Ooh, that is pretty. Okay, good decision. That was a good decision. And you can apply these with your finger. They're nice and soft, but I kind of like it with a brush because it just helps me pack on more color. Oh, I like these a lot. And then I'm just going to kind of drag it down to my inner corner here a little bit like that. Ooh, I got something in my eye. I added mascara. This is my Lancome Hypnos Drama. This is the most luxurious mascara I own because if you know me, you know I don't believe that mascara needs to cost over $20 to be good, but I got that on sale and I actually love it. I'm going to take the shade Smoke from that Natasha Denona palette and I'm just going to smoke out my bottom line with that soft brown color with the angled brush. And I'm going to just keep it at the top and give myself a little wing at the bottom to connect with that eyeshadow up top. There we go. This palette has a cream blush. I'm going to be using a little bit of that. And then I think if this is still pliable. Oh, it is. It's a lot on the brush. I'm going to go over. I'm going to take some of that off because I don't want my blush to be super heavy because my eye is smoky. And I'm going to go over this with the Patrick Ta blush palette, but I'm just going to use the powder. This is also something that I would consider luxury because of the price point, but also Patrick Ta blushes are insane. Insanely good in a very good way. So I'm going to take this one. This is the shade She's Blushing. This is the duo. And I'm going to take a little bit of that powder and put that right. Ooh, not that much, girl. Not that much. Put that right over the cream of the Natasha Denona blush because they're similar in color. And I just, ooh, yes, yes, yes. That is so pretty. Cream and then the powder over top. And that's what we're doing for blush. Ooh, I like that a lot. As far as higher end or luxury lip products go, I think the only pricey lip liner that I have, other than my MAC lip pencils, is the Charlotte Tilbury lip liner. So I'm going to use this one in the shade Pillow Talk Medium as just kind of a base to see. And then I'm going to use a MAC lip gloss, lipstick, because I looked around in my stash and I think I have more higher end complexion products than I do lip products, and I have so many lip products. The only thing that I've been eyeing that's quote unquote a luxury lip product lately is the new Dior matte lipsticks. I kind of want a couple of those neutral ones, but that's okay. So we're gonna go in with Touch from MAC, or should I do Whirl? Let me see. I think Whirl is more of a matte color, and with the eyes, I think I'm gonna go with Whirl. And we're just going to do Matte Whirl over that Charlotte Tilbury lip. And it is, yeah, that's kind of too cool tone. So I'm going to take a little bit of Velvet Teddy and put that in the middle. And blend it too. And to me, MAC lipstick is still luxury high end because one of these little suckers is like $25. So I mean, I don't know what y'all consider luxury, but I kind of like this lip combo, though. With the Charlotte Tilbury, Velvet Teddy, and Whirl all together, it just gave me a nice little finish to this. Let me see if I can get you closer. I like that. I like these two colors together. To finish off the look, I added a little bit of MAC Oh Baby lip gloss. To me, this is so luxury. And for me, it's just a little bit nostalgic because this is one of the first things that I used to buy when I first started purchasing makeup. It was like considered super high end to me. I could not afford MAC. So I would go to MAC like every 2 months and buy one thing that I could afford. And the MAC Oh Baby lip gloss was just one of those things. So it's still so pretty and it's just like super nostalgic for me. So this is the look that I came up with using some of my higher end products. I really like how everything is looking under my eyes. That Kevin Aucoin skin enhancer, I haven't used that in so long, but it just looks like a nice, luxurious, pretty face. And again, you guys know you don't have to spend a ton of money on makeup, even though the drugstore prices are creeping up just a little bit, but you can find good deals at the drugstore as well. I just wanted to pull out some of my things, my higher end things that I don't always reach for. Thanks so much for tuning in today, guys. I hope you enjoy this look. I know that right now makeup is a luxury for a lot of people, sometimes even myself included, which is why I have been adamant about shopping my stash this month, truly just reaching in to see what I already have. And I'm so glad I did, because I completely forgot about that Natasha Denona palette, but look at all the looks it gave me. A complete eyeshadow look, blush, the whole thing. And you guys know how I feel about my Givenchy, the concealer and the foundation. So I really am feeling this look. I feel like it's going to be a million selfies that I'm going to take after this. Let me know what you guys think about this. If you made it this far in the video, go ahead and hit that thumbs up and that subscribe button so you don't, and turn on your notifications so you don't miss a thing. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I will see you guys back here. It won't be such a long break this time. February's just been an crazy busy month for me in a lot of ways. So thanks for hanging in there. Thanks for watching my shorts, and thank you so much for those who have already booked their appointment for their beauty consulting services. I will see you very, very soon at your appointment time. Thanks again for watching, guys. Bye.